Hello, my dear fragrant friends. Welcome back to the channel again. And today I have a special perfume for all of you. This is really, really special. Perfume connoisseurs, watch out for this one. This is known as Oud Gulfam from Agarwood Assam. Agarwood Assam had done Laos 99, the beautiful oud oil with spiritual abilities, which I had featured in one of my episodes. It was just a fantastic, mind-boggling experience. I then later on added a bottle to my arsenal. These are the same guys, Agarwood Assam, and they have come out with 100% natural attar. Alright, I'm in love with this attar, that's why I'm featuring it. I've been testing it for quite some time now, and they recently launched it on Etsy. This is a sampler, of course, and I will order a bottle soon. As of now, I'm out of funds. So this is how the final product is going to look like. This is a quarter tola bottle. This is actually the oud oil which I obtained from Agarwood Assam, pure Indian agarwood oil, which has also gone into making of this attar. So this attar is a perfume oil, of course, and a very beautiful one. You know, you remember those times when the Indian spice market was popular in the Mughal period. They used to make some of the most royal attars in and around the area of Kannauj, with the finest rose, with the finest saffron, Kashmiri saffron, with the finest Indian agarwood, which was just wild, not your fruity, custardy sort of ouds that you find today from plantations. It was just fantastic, overwhelming, with a lot of complexity, character development. And we also have some Laos oil in here, which is extremely beautiful, lighter greenish sort of oud. So all of those elements, those fantastic elements, have gone into making of this attar, guys. It almost gives you the feel of the royalty, Indian royalty, which used to bathe in rose oil and milk and whatnot. Anyway, so coming back to this perfume oil, this is a fantastic creation, absolutely gorgeous. I know, as a reviewer, I shouldn't get excited about things, but this is 100% natural attar, guys. I mean, come on. Now, even if you go to the most luxurious stores in the Gulf region and you try their special reserve perfumes, yes, I have sampled many, many oils like that, guys. So I can tell you, really expensive, luxurious items sent to me as gifts from friends in the fragrance community. Thank you so much, guys. This is 100% natural. Even the finest attars sold in the market, in the conventional market, would use at least the finest bits of aroma chemicals to enhance the smell. And there's nothing wrong with it, guys, because not everybody will be able to relate with natural elements, you know, because the rose today, what we imagine the smell, it's not exactly like your pure roses. There's a fictional note created in the market, you know. Now our association with smells is absolutely controlled by market, until, of course, you are associated with natural flora around you, around your house. Maybe you have some fragrant flowers in your garden. You know the real aromas of things. Jasmine sambak, how it smells. Your Bela Indian jasmine, northern jasmine, how it smells. You know the smell of French lavender. You know the smell of spikenard. So if you are, if you are used to such smells, you are definitely one of the customers of these guys, because they deal with natural perfumery. Natural perfumery is so natural to you. You never feel that you're wearing an alien perfume which is irritating your nasal mucosa. It never chokes you out. It never chokes you out. That's the best part about natural perfumery. It's subtle, extremely sophisticated. There's no loudness, there's no flamboyance to it. It's just pure, it's just soulful, it's you can say very, very complex, very fine, and you need a real focus to understand what's going on with the scents. Anyway, so the scent has all those elements. It also utilizes some jasmine sambak from India, the most precious rose that India has produced over the years. It's from Hosayan, the area around Kannauj, and it's known as Ruh Gulab, just like Ruh Khas or the North Indian vetiver. It's pristine, it's crystal clear rose, absolutely sparkly. There is no creaminess to it, there is no regular smell of rose to it. It's light pinkish rose petals floating in water, and it's got a pristine aroma which is almost sparkly, silvery, sort of greenish freshness to it, extremely, extremely beautiful and overwhelming. It's so sensual, so arousing. I don't have words to describe it. If you can find your find yourself some of the Rugla, which is extremely costly, of course it costs about 15 to 25 lakhs in the market, you'll consider yourself extremely lucky. It's just out of this world. Anyway, so he's put that in here. He's also put wild agarwood oil from the Assam region, which has a barney character, of course, but it's not your overwhelming dark manure-ish sort of opening which you get from over fermentation of the wood. This is very high quality wood. It does not need to be soaked for a very long time. It's got leatheriness to it, which is very fine, very tobacco like, very caramelic sweet aroma to it. It's got depth. There is Kashmiri saffron again, which is one of the most expensive ingredients out there, used for fragrance and flavors all over the world. Very, very delicate, tobacco-like, dry, airy aroma. It's so, so fantastic. It's soft. It's never overwhelming. And then you've got Indian jasmine, a touch of jasmine sambak. Jasmine sambak is basically your South Indian variety, which is also known as Mogra. It's a pristine aroma. It's got a sweet metallic tone to it, and it's quite faint in this attar. What basically comes to your nose is a whiff of roses, soft, sweet, subtle roses, and you have the spicy aroma of saffron. When saffron and rose combine, it's a totally different aroma. The oud, the harshness or the strength of oud is definitely controlled by the rose and saffron here, and it becomes lighter, all right? They've also thrown in hints of aged Laotian ouds, namely Laos 99 and Raja Laos 1995 from the same house, which have spiritual dimensions. All right, those are Laotian ouds done the Indian way, but those are green. Those have that spiritual incense-y aroma that will make the most spiritual oud users crazy. It also has a large dose of Mysore sandalwood, which is pure and which is aged Indian sandalwood, which was also distilled by these guys. And it couples so very well with the oud in the drier stages the last stages of this perfume on your skin. Gives out a beautiful, spicy, woody aroma. So playful. There's such an inexplicable interplay of notes. Very complex, but you will feel the dimensions of it because it's just overly, overly beautiful. Extremely well done. So it's got the best of everything. Now as a perfume, now as a fragrance, where does it stand? I feel if you are into natural perfumery, if you are using very high quality ingredients, if you seek only the best, the most expensive stuff, not based on their market value, not based on their face value, but the actual cost of production of the ingredients, you would know what we have here. This is extremely special. It's got very nice natural tones to it. You just cannot deny the fact that it feels a part of you. It feels like an envelope. It is extremely, extremely soulful. It's got a lot of development. As soon as you put it on skin, you'll get that oudy, rosy feel, later on developing into something else. The saffron comes out, becomes a little spicy. Hints of those sweet, bitter notes from the spiritual ouds hitting you every now and then. So it's got a very nice development for a natural product, and it's extremely satisfying, very cozy scent. I have fallen in love with this, and the best part, guys, it only costs $90 for a quarter tola or 3 ml, 2.5 grams, whatever. Guys, I'm telling you, $90 is extremely, extremely cheap because it's an introductory offer. If this perfume was put in a proper luxurious bottle, luxurious presentation that you are used to in the Gulf region, of course, this would cost easily around $500 to $600. I'm not kidding. I have a lot of others. You've seen all those, right? This beats them just because it's natural. And I'm not saying that because somebody has told me it's natural. I play with natural scents every day. I keep experimenting, and I can tell you guys, this is one hell of a fragrance. I'm in love with it. Usability, yes. You can wear this fragrance easily outside, but the top could be a little overwhelming for people who are not used to such pure ouds and others, all right, you have to take in consideration the people around you, the social environment that you're in. You don't want to annoy those people with those heavy top notes. Let the fragrance settle down for in about 30 minutes or so, and then you can wear this fragrance outside easily. It's not got a huge projection, but the top notes will immediately explode off your skin. That's the thing with Indian oud. It'll settle down in 30 minutes. Don't worry about that. You'll get a decent scent bubble around you. The sillage is going to be really nice. People around you, especially in close proximity, will be able to smell it off you. And they'll definitely ask you what you're wearing, because it's one of those special perfumes. Especially if you want to give something to a person from royalty, this would make for an ideal gift. The most pristine Indian perfume that I have found in the recent years. So yes, that was the review of this beautiful attar, my friends. I'll share the links down in the video description. So just in case if you are interested in buying this perfume, you can go there, check it out. You can also acquire samples if they have. So yes, that's it, guys. Tomorrow, I'll be joining you again with a review on some perfumes, maybe, or probably deal with some pure oud oils from the House of Imperial Oud, United Kingdom. That's it, guys. Take care. Bye-bye. See you again.